Hello viewers, welcome to Elim TV, a station where you watch, interact and also learn. Your tutor today is Mr. Wanyoike, an agriculture teacher. In today's lesson, we are in Form 4, Lesson 3, and the topic is poultry production. The subtopic, we are going to look on egg handling and also explain the type of incubation. On to the lesson objective. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to, number one, explain the meaning of egg candering, and number two, demonstrate the process of egg candering, and number three, explain two types of incubation. Then we have come to the term egg candering, and egg candering refer to the method of examining the internal condition of an egg for abnormalities by looking it against a strong light in a dark room. You can see it is well demonstrated here. We have the yolk there, and you can use a source of light like a torch, whereby you can see in the second diagram there is a torch below which is lit, and therefore it will illuminate all the parts of the egg, and therefore if there is any abnormality in the egg, you can easily see and also detect it. Then the process of egg candering, you're supposed to carry out egg candering for those eggs which are meant for breeding. On the fourth day, you should make sure that you carry out egg candering to make sure that the egg do not have crack eggshell, it is not double yolked. On the day 10 also you do another egg candering to make sure that the egg is fertilized, and on day 17 you are supposed to carry once again the egg candering, and in this case you are supposed to, it is meant for identifying whether the chick has already started to develop and grow. Then we will go to methods of incubation, and as far as incubation is concerned, we discussed the meaning in the previous lesson, and therefore what are the types of incubation? In today's lesson we are going to concentrate on methods of incubation, and the first one, we have the natural incubation. In this case, the bird is allowed to sit on the egg for the purpose of providing the optimum condition required for the eggs to hatch into chicks. Then what are the advantages of this method of natural incubation? The first one, it is affordable because you are not required to buy the incubator, artificially manufactured machine which is meant for incubation process. Then it is less rebellious because you will not be looking the temperature, because the bird will provide the required temperature. Then number three, literal skills is required, because the bird is very, very skillful when it comes to regulation, or when it comes to checking on the condition, it will just provide the condition necessary for incubation process. Then margin of risk is reduced, because there is no electricity which is used here, but the heat comes from the body of the hen, and therefore it means that since even if there is technical error in the electricity, and the electricity it resorts to blackout, it means that the hen will continue sitting on the egg, and therefore providing the optimum condition which are required for hatching out, and therefore the margin of risk is highly reduced. Then you can see there is an image of a hen there sitting on the eggs, and actually some of the eggs have started to hatch into chicks. Then we come to the disadvantages of this method. A few chicks are hatched, because the birds can only sit for a maximum of 15 eggs, and therefore meaning that the number of chicks which are hatched are few. Then not possible to plan when to hatch, because the birds which is used in this case must be broody. Then high chances of spreading of parasite and diseases. If the hen itself is infected, it means that it will transmit the infection to the to the cheek, then her head can be used only when bleeding. That is, I have already discussed it. We have come to the end of today's lesson, and I'm going to mark the end of this lesson by assigning you some activity. And the first question is, you're supposed to name any two types of incubation, as I have already discussed them in this lesson. Then number two, discuss the various reasons for egg kindling, and therefore you're supposed to mention as I explain them in the course of the lesson. For reference, you can refer to the secondary agriculture student book, book 4, and the publisher is the Kenya Literature Bureau. For more information, you can reach us at LIM TV using the following addresses. The first one, you can use the SMS number, which is well displayed for you. You can also reach us through YouTube at LIM TV, and also Facebook platform at LIM TV. And finally, you can tweet us at LIM_TV_KE. Thank you for joining me in this lesson. Till next lesson. Bye-bye.